questions. In possibilities of a line which can be in first quadrant. Line is parallel to both HP and VP, we have solved. Line is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP is seen. And line is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP is seen. 1, 2, 3, three conditions. Based on these conditions, what all are the learnings that we have got, conclusions and important inferences that we are going to, we have learned here is, if a line is parallel to any plane of projection, if a line is parallel to any plane of projection, its view on that plane of projection will be in its true length. Remember the term true length. True length is the length that was given in the problem. Here also this is in its true length. Here also the line is in its true length because the line was parallel to vertical plane and the image that is formed on this vertical plane is the true length of that particular line. And vice versa, if a line is perpendicular to any plane of projection, that is in this condition line was perpendicular to horizontal plane, then its image form will be just a point. Similarly, if it was perpendicular to VP, if a line was perpendicular to VP, the image formed on VP, that is the front view, will be just a point. Are you able to get it? These are the inferences that we have found out. Very simple, you are making the line parallel. If you keep the line which has got only one dimension, that is the length, if you keep that line parallel to any plane of projection, then its image formed on that plane of projection will be in its true length. So that is very, very important concept of true length that you are supposed to remember and incorporate in your drawings. So what is the next condition? We'll move on to the next condition. Line is, fourth one, the line is parallel to VP and inclined to HP. So we discussed, we just now talked about something about true being true, that is a true length, and true length with respect to the length only. If some inclinations are associated, what will happen? We'll just see it. Line AB 60 mm long is parallel to VP and inclined to horizontal plane at 30 degree and inclined to horizontal plane at 30 degree. One end point A of the line is 10 mm above HP and the line is 20 mm in front of VP. So remember, read the problem carefully. What you are supposed to do here is a line AB 60 mm long is parallel to VP. I am just keeping this first quadrant, keeping a line like this. Line AB 60 mm long is parallel to VP. See, even this is also parallel to VP. but I cannot keep it like this because this is perpendicular to HP. But it should be inclined to horizontal plane. I am keeping it in such a way that it is inclined to horizontal plane, something like this. You keep it like this. See, horizontal, now it is parallel to horizontal plane. I am giving it some inclination from one of its point as 30 degree. It is inclined at 30 degree to HP. One endpoint A, I'll consider this left side endpoint A, left side endpoint A is 10 mm above HP. See, if above HP, this is at a distance of 10 mm and the whole line is 20 mm in front of vertical plane. In front of VP, the whole line is there at a distance of 20 mm. And this endpoint is 10 mm above HP. So that is how we are supposed to solve the problem. How to draw this problem? I'll draw a rough sketch here. Then directly I'm going to construct in my sketchbook. If you are drawing in unrolled book, direct construct it directly. I'm going to draw XY line first to represent that this is first quadrant. This is the very first step. The first step that we are going to do. See the numbers. AB 60 mm long has to be somewhere here, being parallel to VP and inclined to HP and at 30 degree. One endpoint A, we'll fix this one endpoint A. See, 10 mm above HP means somewhere here. I'll start with this line. And the whole line is 20 mm in front of VP is somewhere here. Don't mark any point here as a dark point. Just identify starting point. I have identified it may be something like this. So from here, I'll draw the front view. See, front view is just like this. As it is parallel to VP, this line is 60 mm. And I can name this as one endpoint A, and this as A dash, and similarly this as B dash for a length of 60 mm. So this distance, I am marking it as 10 mm. This distance, see, dimension line is different. Projection line is different. So this is the starting point A. This A is at a distance of 20 mm in front of A. 10 and 20 are on the same line. A and A dash will be on the same projection line. Here A dash, from A dash I have drawn 60 mm line at an angle of 30 degree. So how did I draw this 30 degree? I'll be using this set square. So how would see this set square is 30 degree. See, approximately the freehand sketch is 30 degree that I have drawn. So if you keep the set square here, this angle should be 30 degree. That is very, very important. See, this in set square, this is 30 degree. So use the set square because I have this protractor also. Keeping this protractor here, mark 30 degree and then take a draw a line for 60 mm, you will lose time. So directly I'm marking this 30 degree line and then obtaining this, very, very important. This angle is 30 and this angle is 60, very, very important. So this is 60 mm. Next time I'll use this perpendicular lines to dimension it. Dimension it somewhere here as 60. Rough sketch. This is exactly 60 mm because it is parallel to VP. If it is parallel to VP, I can draw its true length. So what will be the image on the top view? Can anybody unmute and inform? Will it be exactly 60?
Sir, no, sir. It is 180 degrees.
Will be? Straight line, sir.
See, top view.
Straight line.
It's just a straight line. Can you tell me, can you assume what is the length of this top view, AB?
10 mm more, sir. Or less, sir.
Just see, I'm holding it, this line like this, fixing this endpoint A, giving it some inclination. If it is parallel to VP, I can find its true length. If it is inclined to HP, and from here, I'm drawing a point here, and again from B also, I am drawing this location. If I join these two dots on HP, will it be the true length?
No, sir.
Will this top view will be 60 mm? That is my question, that's all.
No, sir.
Anybody can think of any confusion also, please inform me immediately, because this is very, very important. These four problems, I'm solving it on one paper, one sheet, because it is very, very associated with your text positioning. So from here, I take this corner of the set square and draw a 30 degree line. See, this edge, I am marking it, keeping it with respect to the printed line, this edge, and then with this corner, with this point, I am going to draw a line which will be automatically 30. Now you check it, this 30 degrees exactly. See, which reduces a lot of time here. This is over. Next, here 60 mm. You can mark 60 in this set square itself. You can do the same.
It will be less, sir.
Yes, it will be less because it is not parallel. Very simple, very, very simple concept is it is not parallel. I'm going to mark A dash, B dash, and similarly, where A dash is present on the same projector, A should lie at a distance of 20 mm. So here it will be A. This is the A representation, and where B dash is lying for a distance of 60 mm. For a distance of 60 mm, where B dash is lying. From there, I'll draw a projector, a thin line. See, I am using different pencils, so this is for dark. This is an HB pencil, so I'm using it for dark lines. For thin lines, I am using this pencil, where very thin line is obtained like this. Are you able to see the thin line? And similarly, A is here. Top view will be somewhere here. That is according to my actual drawing here, as I have done it in my sketchbook. Here 60 mm I have correct. I have exactly taken it true length because it was parallel to VP. Its projector on horizontal plane has become foreshortened. It is not exactly 60. It is around 52 for me. See here, 52.
Yes, sir. 52, sir.
This 52. If you are constructing parallelly, please do it. And I am not dimensioning this also because now it is not required. But this dimensioning is required. See, what I'll do here is use this set square. See, perpendicularity. I'm maintaining this perpendicularity with this edge here to draw the extension lines. With this edge, I'm drawing this perpendicular line. See, this is the line I have to dimension. Take one box, 10 mm gap, and dimension this as 60. For me, it is 52 mm. This top view is around 52 mm. And this angle I am going to measure here and dimension it as 30 degrees. What else is given? This 10 mm was given and 20 was given in the problem. See the numbers that are printed in the problem in a very simple way. You can complete the dimensioning. All printed numbers in the problem or something is asked in the problem must be dimensioned. Very simple. Completely in this subject. Front view. Okay. Now tell me, front view, is the front view is in true length?
Yes, sir.
The front view is in its true length. Is the top view in its true length?
No, sir.
I will just parent length or foreshortened length. Very simple, I can say that it is foreshortened length. I will just show. Purposely, I have not see. Line is parallel to VP and inclined to HP. You can see here this pink color. What you are seeing, this is the actual line, capital letter AB. I am seeing this endpoint B and projecting it to vertical plane. This is B dash, and I am seeing this A endpoint and projecting it to vertical plane as A dash. This inclination is associated with the true length. See, it is parallel to VP means this inclination is associated with the true length. See here, I can see the true length and true inclination theta. Very, very important. In vertical plane, it is called as theta. Similarly, it has got other names in other planes of projection. We are going to see it here. But front view is directly seen here, and top view, if you see the same object from top, see from A, endpoint A, I am projecting it towards the horizontal plane. This is A. Similarly, from end B, I am projecting it towards the horizontal plane. This is B. If I join this top view, it will not be in its true length because this is inclined to HP. This is very much inclined to HP. So you will not be able to see that exact length on horizontal plane. If it is parallel, then only I will be able to see to it. So it is very, very important to know. So in 2D drawing, XY line, A dash, A, whatever distance it is above HP and in front of VP, the views will be same. Front view and top view will be same. Here in this problem, I have taken 10 and 20. Even if it is 15 and 20, or if it is 50 and 100, or 1000 and 1000, front view remains same. Got it? Because this is a definite space, this is an infinite space. Vertical plane is an infinite space. Wherever you are imaginarily keeping it behind the object and representing its views. So it is not exactly there actually, but in order to position it and draw it as in a 2D drawing in my sheet, I am giving some dimensions to these problems. So the 10 and 20 and whatever it is. Even if I give 1000 and 2000, the front view remains same. It will be exactly 60 mm only. This will be 5200. You imagine, change the dimension and just check one more drawing. The front view and top view will remain same. That is 10 and 20. If you fix it, change only 10 and 20 mm, not the 60 mm. So with the length of the line, front view and top view will remain same. And true length is associated here in the front view. And similarly, the inclination associated with this true length is called as true inclination theta. Very, very important. I'm marking it in my 30 degree drawing also, that it is inclined to HP, and inclined to HP 30 degree is represented as theta. That is the true inclination. Very, very important. It is the true inclination, which is called as theta. Here front view is inclined to HP and top view is parallel to XY line. To parallel to XY line means line is not parallel to XY line, VP, please. Line is not parallel. Remember, line is inclined to HP, and front view means line is parallel to VP, but this is front view is inclined to XY line. This is with respect to XY line, the representations are given, not with the original concept. All right, front view is inclined to XY line means it is parallel to VP. Top view is parallel to XY line means it is inclined to HP. So just a simple concept, or remember it, or just imagine this object and represent the same in the conditions. We'll solve the next problem. See, try to solve the problems as I'm solving one next to the other, because it is very easy for us to remember and represent. So next condition, see here, line is parallel to HP and inclined to VP. So parallel to HP and inclined to VP. See, this is a line AB, which is inclined to VP at some angle. I will call it as phi, because true inclination with VP will always be called as phi. Very, very important. which is associated with the true length always. And top view is somewhere here inclined at some angle, 45 degree or 40 degree. And top view length AB will be exactly of the true length. And angle associated with this true length will be named as phi because it is on HP. This is a particular standard that we are using. And here, will the front view be exactly 60 mm?
Yes.
No, sir.
Will the front view be exactly 60 mm?
No, sir. No.
Again, this is a foreshortened length. See, if it is an incline to any plane of projection, then it is a foreshortened length. Very, very important. It can be easily seen and understood that if a line is inclined to any plane of projection, then the image form will be foreshortened. As the B location is here, we have found out this condition and we are solving this problem. So, next problem. Line AB of 60 mm long is parallel to HP and inclined to VP at 45 degrees. Draw the projections of the line if the line is 20 mm above HP and 1 endpoint is 10 mm in front of VP. Just the title and drawings will be represented. What I'll do here is, it is just a vice versa of this image. So draw XY line. First thing that you do is draw XY and VPHP, a rough sketch. In your examination, like this, booklets will be given of some pages. So here you are going to draw it properly. So left hand side, there will be empty sheet. Please write the rough sketch here so that you will come to know the exact answer, predict the answer properly, know the procedures properly, and then answer it. See, it is 60 mm long. It is the true length that I know. And then it is inclined to VP at 45 degree. The line is inclined to VP at 45 degree. And you have to draw the projections, means orthographic projection only. If the line is 20 mm above HP, the whole line is around 20 mm above HP, means two boxes. And one of its endpoints is 10 mm in front of VP. So 10 mm in front of VP, somewhere here, I'll be drawing a 45 degree line using a 45 degree set square. Or you know how to draw a 45 degree line by joining the boxes, diagonal of the box that is printed in your sketchbook. Or use this set square, you directly 45 degree, I have kept it here, and draw a line here for 60. This is 60 mm line which I have drawn here, 60 mm, and then name it as A and B because one endpoint is 10 mm in front of VP. This endpoint I am going to name it as around 10 mm. So where A is there, here also at a distance of 20 mm, A dash will lie. So front view will be somewhere here. So from B, I'm going to draw a projector above where it meets from A dash. So this is the front view that I'm making it dark. So front view of a line will be like this, A dash, B dash. A dash, B dash will not be in its true length. So 45 degree, that is 5. And this is 60. I'm going to draw this here. with your distance of 16. So directly I'm going to draw here. So without wasting time. VPHP XY. I'm going to draw it like this. Next, I'm going to start somewhere here. 10 mm at a distance of 10 mm. Take 45 degree line or join the diagonals, no problem. Whatever methods you follow, method should be appropriate. And this edge I'm matching it with the printed line. This edge I'm matching it with the printed line and draw a 45 degree line. I'm drawing a 45 degree line and use this to mark it for 60 mm. So use it to mark for 60. Somewhere here is 60. And name it as B. So where A is there, from there I'll draw a projector above. And where should it stop? Around 20 mm. So 20 mm means two boxes. So two boxes, this is the location of A dash. So similarly, from B I'm going to draw a projector above. Thin line, see, same pencil, don't apply pressure. Thin line you draw. And from A dash to, this is B dash, this is the location of B dash. I'll be drawing the front line, the dash and the dash. Dimension 20 here on the printed line, dimension 10 here. See, this 20 and 10, don't worry about it much, because I told you, even if you are varying for any distance, the front view and top view, the views will remain unchanged and not be affecting. So this is top view. Here, perpendicular line, I can draw it by a set square, or see a scale. These are the printed lines here, 2, 3, 4, 1, or the centimeter scale. Some black color printed lines are there. Some printed lines like this, 2, 3, 4, these markings are the printed lines on the scale. I'm marking it exactly. See, here 2, I'm marking it like this. For example, I will be placing 2 here for 2 printed line. And then draw a perpendicular line. See, this edge, the scale edge will become perpendicular to keep that line. And see, for 4, I'm keeping it here somewhere like this. And then draw a projector. I mentioned 60. And draw the dimension line. See, dimension line will be exactly parallel. See, here this is parallel. This is means it is exactly parallel. So front view, I'm marking it like this, and top view will be in its full length. Very, very important. Front view is this foreshortened length. For me, it is, you can see, count here only, it is around 44 or 43, four boxes just before the 45, it is there. So you can count it by scale also, it is 44, 43, 44, in between 43 and 44, I have got this front view. When I have got this dimensioning, 45 degree, as phi, theta and phi, very, very important. Theta is inclination to HP along with its true length. Phi is inclination to VP along with its true length. Very, very important. If you know this only, we will be able to solve this next condition. Please answer to me if there is any doubt. Doubts that are there with these conditions. Please, anybody unmute yourself, because this is very, very important, and this cannot be neglected. Mechanical students or civil students, and because that is where your projections and concepts will lie, and you need to represent the same. What is the inference that we do, that we get from here, is if a line is in its true length, if the line is parallel to any plane of projection, we get its true length. That is what we understand here. If the line is inclined to any plane of projection, For example, it is inclined to HP in this first in this condition. So fourth condition, in this condition, it is inclined to HP means the image form will be foreshortened, or the top view that is seen will be foreshortened. Simple, it is 60 mm line is the actual true length. Here it have got around 52. Same way 60 mm for 45 degree, if it is inclined to VP, then the front view that is seen here will be foreshortened. That is inclination to VP, the front view is foreshortened. I have got 44. So more you incline, lesser the lines will become. Complete line, you are able to see this complete scale. To this paper, I am making it parallel. If you keep on inclining it, I am giving some inclination to the paper, that is inclination to horizontal plane, right? So as you can see, now if it is a rectangle, slowly it becomes a square. At one point, it can become a square like this, right? So that is what the representations and everything will come into picture. So these four representations are very, very important. Just I'm going to keep it like this. Still, you take a screenshot. Anyway, I'll be sending it, but it is very, very important that you incorporate these things in your drawing and represent the same. Based on these concepts, six concepts, what are the six concepts? I'll be opening this previous problem also. What are the six concepts? Line is parallel to VP.
VP and HP. Parallel
to VP and HP. Yep.
Parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP.
Parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Here it is.
Parallel to HP
and perpendicular to VP. Parallel to VP.
Inclined to.
Here it is. Parallel to HP. Inclined to VP. Inclined, and there directly I have represented like this, theta and phi. Inclination with respect to HP will be given as theta. Inclination to VP will be always represented as. So these six five conditions, parallel to VP and HP, and parallel to VP, perpendicular to HP, parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP, which are vice versa. Similarly, here also parallel to VP, inclination to HP, parallel to HP, inclination to VP. These are the simple conditions, and very, very important. You look at these drawings. This is the representation I need in your drawings. For example, thin line and thick line. I told you here, see, with the same pencil, whatever pencil you are having, this is HB pencil. It is printed on the pencil here. Please use the such type. Same pencil. You can make a dark line also. You can make a thin line also. Much more thin line also. You can make, see, three types of lines can be drawn. So objects, my object, line, plane. Next, it can be circle, rectangle, some planes. If you start in the next chapter, all these things will be drawn in this particular style. Next, projection lines. If this projection lines, like, see, from front view to this top view, or top from top view if you are projecting upwards, or from front view are projecting it downwards, these lines will be thin lines. You can use this type of pencil. And for front view also, front view and top views, always these views, front view, top view, A dash, B dash, A, B, A dash, B dash, A, B, these lines will be dark. So try to use 2B pencil, or you make some huge impressions like this in the HB pencil, using HB pencil itself. Same pencil, you can make both the types. See, three types can be drawn here. Dimensioning line will be thin, very, very thin. See, dimensioning lines will be thin. Those are, and this is an extension line. So how did I draw this extension line? Use the set square. See, I have used the set square. I have used this perpendicularity. so that I have kept this perpendicularity like this and draw the extension line, because this is the object that I need. Similarly, 30 degree, use this set square for 30 degree. I am using this set square for 30 degree like this, inside or outside. You can keep it outside. Whenever you want to draw a line outside, how will you keep this edge? I am keeping it as a reference on the printed box line. This edge, I am keeping it here, and then I am drawing this. This edge, this angle will be 30 degree. Same way, if you want 60 degree, I can draw it like this, use it like this. So that is how you are supposed to represent and use the set squares to reduce a lot of time. This I am incorporating in my drawings from right now itself, because it is very, very essential, and it will save a lot of time in the examination. Perpendicular line, I told you here, one more concept, the old concept, simple line. If this is a line, I want to draw a perpendicular line, means, see this printed markings on the scale, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 1, 2, 3, 4, or here in the centimeter scale, any line, any printed line, you can keep it with respect, instead of this edge, you can keep this printed line and draw a line here so that it will be perpendicular automatically, because this edge will be perpendicular to this printed lines. So that is one more easiest way to draw the perpendicular line, so that you will reduce a lot of time to in the examination. Draw a rough sketch and then try to draw this drawing. One second, just wait. See, please inform your friends also. It is very, very important. You cannot neglect this subject.